All right, that was pretty cool. A full slate of local squads trying to continue their march to Madison. There are two sides to the same coin at every game. Last night, Cedarburg-Kimberly, one team's heartbreaking loss was another's dramatic victory. You just hope at the end of the day, you live to see another one. Warhawks head coach Phil Dacca retiring after this season, taking on Marquette and hoping his team's ride would continue. Second quarter Hilltoppers QB John Capriva looks for Matt Misiewicz in the corner of the end zone and actually finds him. The junior wideout drags his toe on the good side of the white line, so it's a touchdown. Still in the second, this time Capriva lets his running back Austin Taylor do the work. Off tackle for the 17-yard score, MUHS up 20-6. Capriva using his arm one more time in the quarter, hitting Alex Ash for the 32-yard connection after the defender helps him out a little bit. Coach Dacca calls it a career after 41 incredible seasons at Germantown. Because Marquette wins this one 41-27, they will face Stevens Point next week. More D1 action, Waukesha West taking the field and taking on Middleton. Cardinals opening drive, Scott Carey getting out of trouble, finding Kevin Patternell. It's a 25-yard gain. The crowd goes wild. That effort would set up a 5-yard touchdown by Jamie Hoffer. Hoffer getting the glory, of course, all the work on the previous play. West would answer, however. Check out the nice run by Joe Schobert. The 6'2 junior nearly makes it to the goal line, but pulled down just before it. Don't you worry, he'd get in on the very next play. Waukesha West wins this one 27-10. The Wolverines will take on Kenosha Bradford next week. Now, every team needs a win to move on, but unbeaten Franklin needed a victory today in order to set up a revenge rematch in the state semifinals against Wanakee, taking on South Milwaukee tonight, where Tom Pippins tried to keep from getting carried away.
Best part about going to Madison is you get to see Jen.
Yeah, Jen's awesome. She is really good.
Hey, Jen, the high-scoring Sabres and those Rockets soaring their best season ever. You'd have to get me kicking and screaming out of here. Hey, what's going on?
Had to pay double to get back in. Double trouble for the host. Down three and stopped on fourth and goal. South Milwaukee yields a 96-yard touchdown drive capped off by this 13-yard toss from Lance Barrett to Anthony Meyer. Barrett threw 5 TD passes. That's 34 in the season. Marcus Schlemm snares the tip pass. It's 31-14. The Sabres have scored 30 or more points in 11 consecutive games. Coach Jeff Clem's D is dynamite too. Dylan Nagulski scoops up Sam Alidin's fumble. Nagulski looks like Bronco Nagurski. 76 yards. 12-0 Franklin stops South Milwaukee super season 45-27.
That's one thing we've done all year, just play till the end, and we did the same thing tonight. I mean, we played an awfully good team, but I'm really proud of our guys.
Thankfully, I got some great receivers to make some plays for me, and our O-line did a fantastic job, and everyone stepped up.
Tom Pippins for the High School Blitz. Jen?
Thank you very much, Pip. Division 3, Delavan Darien visiting McFarland. The Comets were up 14-7 in the second half. McFarland's Tyler Weddle punts the ball to Justin Foltz. He probably shouldn't have done that because Foltz weaves his way around the field. Nobody able to wrap him up. 89 yards later, it's a touchdown to make it 21-7 double D. Remember the punter? Well, he's also the quarterback, and Weddle not having luck there either, getting taken down by Justin Figueroa and eventually out by Delavan Darien. They're moving on 27-14. West Appear Phantoms trying to march past Kewaskum this afternoon. We'll pick this one up in the fourth quarter. Brandon Carter waits a moment for a hole to open up. When it does, he is golden. A 10-yard tutty for the home team. Kewaskum's Cody Nurnberg having all kinds of trouble getting rid of the football, but check out the scrambling ability for what seems like days, then heaving a prayer. It is actually juggled, then caught downfield by Andy Dole. That is just unreal. Nurnberg would struggle to get rid of the ball again here. Ultimately, his squad is spooked by those Phantoms. West Appear beats Kewaskum for the second straight year, 28-21. The Wisconsin Lutheran Vikings, also known as the Vikings we actually like around here, play and host to Catholic Memorial in a D3 matchup. Wisco wasted no time getting on the board. James Harris taking the halfback toss untouched 80 yards to pay dirt. That made it 7-0 in favor of those Vikings. Wisco would put another 7 on the board when they go to the Packers' bread and butter. It's a fullback dive up the gut. Tim Bauman, the guy here, not John Kuhn. Catholic Memorial may be down a pair of scores, but they fight back. Matt Hauser picks off a pass on defense, and it was just what the Crusaders needed. They pull out the win in the second half, beating Wisco 24-17. Check out the lovely sunset at Topper Bowl in Burlington for the Catholic Central game against Potosi. Misdirection pitch by Rex Morrow goes to PJ Floyd, and he chews up 34 yards, finishing in the end zone. It's a 13-6 ball game. Final score of this contest, Burlington moving on 38, Potosi 6. That is going to do it for the High School Blitz this week. Of course, you know, we'll be here each and every week all the way to Madison on the 18th and 19th. Thanks for joining us this evening. We'll send it back over to the ladies at the anchor desk.
Sounds good. Thanks, Jen. Well, a cool view of an extreme sport. Yeah.